right, Coach, you're good to make your opening statement whenever you're ready.
Well, great night. You know, I got a lot of respect for those guys. I've known Jordan for a while. He gets those guys to play extremely hard. And they've got a great identity. You know, they know exactly what they're trying to do in a game. They got 18 offensive rebounds on Florida Gators. And, you know, they're going to play really physical. They're going to get out and press. They're going to get out and pressure you. I thought they did a really good job being the aggressor in ball screen coverages in the first half. And, you know, hedged us and semi-trapped us, you know, at times and made it really hard for some of our guards to get the ball out. And then really in the half court, you know, the first half, it was 10-0 on the offensive backboard. You know, they were plus 10. And I just thought they were the aggressor. But I thought it turned there with about 2.5 minutes to go before halftime. And I thought it started to look like things were getting away from us a little bit. And our guys responded. And that's what this group has been about. And you can see it in these last couple games, you know, at Belmont, get down 6, you know, before to go. Tonight looks like nothing is working. Looks like we can't run offense. Looks like we can't get the ball off the ball screen. Looks like we can't get a rebound. We look a little deflated. They got all the energy. They're getting bench warning and clapping about it. You know, they got all the momentum. And but you know what? And he wouldn't mind me sharing this with you guys. But there was a chance Tyrese Huey wasn't gonna play tonight. And Davis Barnard's been playing well. Right? Cooper Bowser's been playing really well. Garrett Heen's been playing really well. And so minutes start. It's just that it's not always this guy's not good enough. It's like, hey, you know, we got to get minutes to guys that are practicing and playing well. But we couldn't get paint off the glass. And so we said, hey, let's go. And he plays 12 minutes and he's plus 16. And Chuck was phenomenal. But like, at the end of the day, if Reese didn't come in and do that, we don't win tonight. And I think that's the beauty of what this team is showing. They want to play for one another, and they want to play with one another. And it doesn't matter whose night it is. It doesn't matter who gets the credit. There's no ego in it. Let's go try to win a game. And I think that's why they're being rewarded. And you look at, you know, it wasn't necessarily Nick's night. It was Tom's night. Okay, Tom got going. Great, played more. Okay, Coop, not going to play quite as much. Chuck's got 25, and Reese's rebounding. Garrett's got 14 rebounds. Hey, we're good. Ed doesn't play quite as much. He's a redshirt freshman. He's going to be fine. But there's no, you know, Davis was slotted to play more tonight. You know, I wanted to play Davis more tonight. But then Chuck got hot, and then Reese is playing, and Garrett. But you didn't see any expression from the bench, right? There was nothing about themselves. It was all about what we got to do to win the game. And I think that's what, when you keep your connectivity and you can keep your focus on winning, I think that's why in the second half, you know, we go on the 14-0 run. I think they went 6.5 minutes without scoring. And we were able to push the margin to 16. It's a heck of a team win. That's a team win tonight. That's a program win. That's a really good team. They're going to compete in that league, and they're going to win games. Jordan does a great job.
Coach, that kind of felt to me like an ETSU or UNCG game. How beneficial is it to have one of those in the non-conference?
Yeah, I think you know, that's why you challenge yourself. You know, in the non-conference, you play a team like Belmont. It's, you know, it's got some, you know, some Wofford feel to it. It's got, you know, putting a lot of shooters out there, concepts, a little bit. Sanford does it some, you know. And then you play a team like tonight, yeah, you're playing ETSU or Greensboro. They're going to try to physically, you know, beat you up. And, you know, you've got to be able to answer that, right? And I think tonight, for us to not lose the glass, but to tie the glass 39-39, I've told this team, listen, I kept telling them two things all fall. They're not going to recognize you. If you're behind being a team, they're not going to recognize you. Right? Nobody anticipated this group to come out here and defend like we're defending. That wasn't written about. You guys weren't writing about that, right? And all of a sudden, you see a team go out there, and we look like we know how to lock up. And I told them the second thing is, we're big. We got to go play big. It don't do you any good to be big and not play big. We got to go play big. Right? Don't let somebody come in here and say, hey, they're going to punk you. You're like, you got to go play big. And I think tonight that's what they did, right? They showed like, hey, we're going to go rebound. And we didn't do a great job on the first half, but we're big too. And I think it's buying into, you know, Garrett is like, well, can he be a four? Yeah, Garrett can be a four. Looks like he's working out all right. You know, like, but he's playing physical. He had 14 rebounds tonight. And so he's playing the game with an aggression and a physicality that we can do that. right? And you sometimes you think in a game, like, you're either skilled or you're tough. No, like, the best teams, like, you're skilled, you're smart, and you're tough. And we've got to keep building that. And I'll be honest with you, I don't think, I mean, nobody's a finished product right now. But it's not like we're out here starting five seniors. You know, it's not like we got a bunch of, you know, fifth-year COVID guys out there. And I think you're seeing guys, you know, Coop's a true sophomore, Ed's a redshirt freshman, right? Mason's a true freshman. You got some guys that Chuck, he's got 2 years. Tom's got 2 years left. Like, you're seeing some guys that are growing right in front of you. And then you got PJ with the experience there. You got Nick with the experience there. And Garrett, you're coupling all that. But the best thing that this group's doing is they're buying in to playing to the values. Are you willing to be a great teammate? Can we get back to flying around on defense? How we built this whole thing? And can we move and share the ball? And this team is trying to play to that identity. And when you play that identity versus self, you get rewarded with wins. And, you know, we could be sitting here 1-2 easily, right? Belmont could have beat us. We know that. Like, if that shot doesn't go down, we lose. Okay? And tonight, like, the game's getting away from us a little bit. But because of team and because of our connection and because of us drawing to the values, I thought that's what gave us a chance to win that game.
Coach, you know, first of all, I think this is the first game where somebody's got a little bit of film on and kind of can scout you a little better. It was pretty obvious to me that we're going to make a play. And it forces, this is the first time in turn that I think it forced other guys to kind of step up and make shots. Is that something that the coach that you know is going to happen, or is it nice to see somebody take the leadership role and step up and have the confidence like that Charles Johnson did tonight?
Yeah, I think it's the go-to guy's going to be the open guy. And we got a lot of playmakers out there. And, you know, teams have film. I mean, teams get the scrimmages. You know, like Belmont probably had the Auburn exhibition. You know, like, they upset Columbia International. They didn't get shoot. You know, like, people know. You got all the synergy film from Barry, who's averaging 20 a game. That they chose to play it a certain way. And they were really aggressive in the ball screens. We started setting less ball screens. And then Tom got hot. And so some of those calls, you know, I mean, I thought one of the biggest plays of the game was when Tom got fouled, you know, that action. He stole that from UConn. We get really tricky with it around here. Like, you know, it's a great action. And you know, when we got that right there, and Tom got fouled, and right there, made those free throws. But, you know, it's Nick's a competitor. He played 30 minutes. He was plus six. You know, he stepped up there and made those two free throws late when we were kind of, you know, struggling there at the end. And he's just competitive, man. I mean, he's just competitive. He had four steals tonight. And I know I've already touched on 36 deflections, which, you know, I started to think in the modern game that you can't get 30-plus deflections anymore. And I was wrong on that. This team's showing you can. Nick had 10 tonight. So like, okay, it's not your shooting night. It's not your scoring night. Can you go out there and can you compete? And he did, right? And so he gets 10 deflections. He gets four steals. And he affects winning and losing. And he just finds a different way to do it. And, you know, it's like I was saying, right? Like, are you playing to play well or are you playing to win? And Nick Anderson's playing to win.
When the game started, it seemed to me that the first challenge was to get it not slow, but slow down and find a rhythm, because the game began a little frenetic, and that was what they wanted.
Yeah, like, it's actually the opposite. And this sounds counterintuitive. So I wanted to play faster, and I thought that's what we were able to do in the second half. Their pressure made us timid. And so when you're playing a team that's going to hit you in the half court and deny you pressure, you don't want to walk it up so they can sit their heels and all that pressure and then they can just kind of body you, right? Like, you want to try to beat it down and see if you can get ahead of it and then play, right, to where they can't just, they're just playing from, you know, a set entry. And I thought their pressure slowed us up. Like, I thought we had times where we came out of the gate defending. It was 3-3 the first, you know, 4 minutes of the game. But we were timid pushing the ball, right? We didn't get through the circle. We didn't really push the ball down the floor. And it played into their hands. And it's the old John Wooden, right? Like, you want to play fast, but you don't want to play hurried. And we want our competitive advantage to be a run, right? We got 10, 11 guys we can play. Like, let's get out. Let's go. And then now, get them on the run, get them on the move, and let's see if we can keep them on the move. And I thought you saw that in the second half tonight. When PJ gets it, we start pushing, we start kicking ahead, we start getting some rim runs. And then now, all of a sudden, you know, you want to be clean. But that was actually a huge part of the game plan.
four steals and all the assists, the rebounds, and everything else. To play that in that kind of game without getting a foul and drawing seven, that's got to be a pretty great night.
You know, y'all heard me say it before, but Brad Stevens always said the game honors toughness. And it does. PJ, he's as tough as they get. And I did think they had him a little rattled at first. You know, listen, this is his second game as a point guard for the Paladins. You know, it's second, third game for Garrett at the four for the Paladins. So we're shifting those roles. And, like, this is the first time he's been hedged like that. Like, even Auburn didn't come out and hedge the ball screen like that. So you got to feel it. And then I got to help him with it. We got to put it in concepts that he can get the ball out of the court. But he didn't lose his composure. And that's one thing he does. Like, he plays the game with a very poker face, right? He really does a good job keeping his composure. And, man, he hit that three, you know, probably, what, 6-7 minutes into the game. I felt like that was like, okay, good. Saw what good. We got off of some ball screens. We started trying to get more of some of our flare screens and screen action off the ball a little bit. But he's just tough. I mean, he's just tough. He plays hard. And I thought as he got a little bit more comfortable, just kind of, he's hard on himself, so he doesn't want to make mistakes. And so sometimes when he makes a mistake, he thinks about that mistake a little too long. And I want him to just have a short-term memory. Just get off of it. Go do the next right thing. And just go lead this team. I thought the last 30 minutes of the game, I thought he did.
There were two plays there in the first half where they were just, it seemed like they were just charging the perimeter and just selling out to not let you guys shoot from the perimeter. And then I think it was Garrett had one on a backdoor feed, and then Nick had one where it appeared as he couldn't shoot and then hits the back cutter at the last second. In general, having guys that have the ability to not only shoot but are skilled enough to be able to make that split decision, is that something that is more impromptu, or is that something you guys work on? I mean, for this game particularly, but
we work on that a lot. You know, we thought a big key to the game tonight, we needed to run them. You know, we needed to cut them, and we knew that the pressure was going to be intense. We knew it was going to be real. You know, I think, you know, when they were having advantages, our feet weren't moving. You know, when we were having advantages, our feet were moving. And I think that, you know, typically we've always been a great cutting team. And we got smart, heady players. And you got to make decisions. You got to see what's in front of you. And you got to figure out what's going on. But, you know, like second half, we got Gio baseline burn right there from Dunn. We had multiple cuts. And I felt like, you know, watching the game, I thought we could even do a little bit more. But, you know, you want to run to the ball. That kind of feeds into what they're doing, and you got to be willing to cut. And sometimes cutting is sacrificial, but if you can cut, and you can cut hard, you can create scoring opportunities, but more than likely you're going to create help. And if you can pull help or set pressure, now we can kind of loosen up the next play, you kind of get some advantages there. And so, you know, the cutting was important. I thought we struggled with it at the beginning of the game. I thought their pressure was kind of keeping our feet still, but as we got our feet going, you can see, you know, we were able to loosen some. Like I said, 14 turnovers, you know, a touch too high. But when you're playing a team that plays like that, I mean, fortunately, we created 14 turnovers. So, you know, you look at the turnover margin, we were actually plus 1 points off of turnovers. And I thought that was a huge part of the game.
This team, it seems to me, is unique among yours because it has had to be assembled so quickly and made cohesive. And I wonder how much of a challenge that has been, and for what preparation, what did you do to prepare for this task?
Well, I think, you know, when you go through a year last year, it was a good year, but not a great year. And, you know, you look at games and you win 17, which we kind of laugh about that, right? Like, it's like, hey, we still have a winning season. It's not, you know, made it to the semifinals, but we didn't quite have the year we thought we could have. You got to assess that myself to everything, right? And, you know, when you go into a recruiting period, you got to make sure you hit on those things that you feel like you need to improve in. And, you know, you go back in those situations and you're like, okay, how do we build all this? Like when we were winning 7, 9 games, 11 games, can see when you watch us play, like our guys care for one another. They want to play for one another. The game's fun. This game is about synergy, right? We've gotten into this world right now. We think this is golf and tennis out here. This isn't golf and tennis. This is basketball. Like, this is art. This is five guys working together. And there's certain talents that, like, you're gonna need to be able to produce buckets. But at the end of the day, like, if you want to get to your absolute best, you got to get five guys working as one. And so we really watch that recruiting. Like can we find some guys that really want to pour into the team? You know, then the whole summer was about connection. It was about reestablishing our connection and really making sure we got to know one another. And then we had to spend the fall really working on our leadership. And I had to really get involved in helping our team lead better. And because you look at it, just game after game, we just didn't close, we didn't finish well. And, you know, the fun thing right now with this group, when you go out there on the court with them, like, they like one another. They like playing for one another. And they're connected. And I think you're seeing that. And you gotta find a group that wants to do that. And the portal's going to make it hard, right, because it's quick. I mean, it's quick now. And that thing opens up, and then, hey, you almost go into, like, you go into a PI mode. Right? You got to find out a lot of information really quickly. And I think right now, like, hey, you know, people say you can't do program anymore and this stuff. Like, you can still do program. There's no doubt about it. You better have an identity. Like, you better know what you're going to recruit to and what you need in order to be able to play with your values, because it's going to happen so fast. And if you don't, like, you might have a lot of talent, but, like, are you going to have a team? And I think for us, it just fits. It fits the whole, what Furman stands for is university. You know, a top 50 liberal arts education in the country. It's got the national brand that they have, right? That we want to have a program that's not a subculture. We want to have a program that identifies with what Furman shows nationally, right? That we care about, hey, winning in life, right? Getting a degree that's unique. You know, being in the Further the Man program and walking across that stage at the same time competing for championships. And then figuring out, like, how do you leverage all this to go build the rest of your life, so when you look back on it, you're like, hey, those 4 years impacted my life. Mm-hmm. Go ask Andrew Brown and Jeff Beans and all these guys out here if the Further Man program impacted their life. And so then you have to have people that say, yes, I want this. And what I kept telling recruits in the spring was, I said, hey, we're going to make this impossible to come here for the wrong reasons. This is what this is. And this is what this is going to be. And what's been neat is we're seeing a team that, hey, you know, I had to have my, we'll see how all that shakes out. But I'll tell you this, you can see a team out there, and you can see a bunch of guys that care about one another. And you can see guys, you know, going out there to make plays for one another and celebrating. I mean, how happy were those guys tonight for Chuck Johnson? Because he's been hurt, he's been injured, he's been battling, but they care about one another. And, you know, so listen, it's hard right now. I mean, this is different now. I mean, it's just, you know, it's a different time. And you don't have to complain about it. You don't have to whine about it. You just, at the end of the day, what's my purpose as a coach? Like, what am I trying to do? I want to lead young men. I want to have an impact on them that makes a difference in their life, like, sincerely, where they look back on all this and they're like, hey, regardless of how I play tonight or not, like, Tyrese Huey learned a lesson about life tonight. Tyrese Huey learned a lesson about life tonight. He had a choice to make. He's going to come in that game, and he's going to show me, hey, coach, I'm mad about this because you're not playing me enough. Or he was going to sell out. He was going to say, you know what, I'm going to do whatever I can do for this team to win a game. And in my opinion, when I'm talking to Reese in 10 years, we're going to talk about the Jacksonville game. And that's why I do this. That's what that's the fun for me. And so, you know, we've got to be comfortable enough being different in this, you know, quote-unquote new age. And we got to know what our identity is. We got to know who we're playing for. And, you know, it makes the game a lot more fun when you get a group working as one.
What little I know, it's been very impressive. I
mean, well, we got worried. Definitely you've been worried. Everybody's been worried.
Yeah.
Right? That's fine. That's okay.
Worry is what makes you prevented.
That's okay. You know, y'all were worried after my first year. We lost all those seniors. I mean, you know, it's what makes this thing fun. Is like, everybody wants to write about who people have coming back and who people got in the portal. Like, hey, let's not forget, like, this is going to come down to team now. And, you know, this league's had six winners the last 6 years. When you go back and look at it, last year Sanford had the best team. That was clear. They played 11 guys. They were all bought in. It was a role. They had enough talent. They had the best. 2 years ago, we had the best team. We had leadership that was unique. We had Mike Bothwell. We had Jalen Slauson. We had guys worked around it, right? We had great roles, everything, and we had the best team. We won. Look at Mike Young's team this last year, the best team, right? You look at some of Forbes' teams. You look at some of West's teams, right? Like when you go back and you look at it, like the best at the end of the day, it's not necessarily the most talent. It's going to be the best team, and I think the challenge in all this is like, you know, hey, Warren Buffett, man, be fearful and greedy, and greedy and fearful. Like I get it. Like hey, you got to get in that portal. Well, you better figure out how to assemble a team, and you know, I think that's something that we've gotten comfortable saying this is what we're going to do, and then we'll let the noise be the noise. We're having fun, and we got a group that's willing to play for one another. And that doesn't mean we're going to win them all. We let me be clear about this. We're a long way from a finished product. I mean, we fumbled around and threw that thing all over the gym trying to close this game out just there. There's some things we're going to have to keep getting better at. But if our spirit stays right, if we keep playing to the values, if we keep things in perspective about what this is all about, I think what you're going to see is this team's not getting, they're not done. They're going to keep getting better.
Awesome. Thank you so much.